Couple of koalas in here, one of my favourites. And this big fella, Roger, I put him in last night to breed with a couple of the girls. And he's down on the ground having a sniff. But every morning, I come and say hello, give him a belly scratch. He's a five-year-old male. While he's there, it's good to see. Each koala has two thumbs, three fingers, which is really good for gripping onto the perch. Look at his mouth open. Did you do your job, mate? You have a big night? How good is that? Follow the page if you want more of this.
Zach, what are we doing?
So we're just about to extract venom from a coastal tire, third most toxic snake on the planet, and this particular animal is our naughtiest one we have. He's whitey. So what I'm going to do, use my finger as the target, so he wants to bite the knee, not the jar, and ready to do the old switcheroo, get your finger out the road, there we go. Now, by doing this, we're able to save between 300 and 500 lives every year, and this doesn't hurt the snake in any way, shape, or form. The plastic on top is stretched to about the same tension or tightness as human skin, so he literally just thinks he's bitten onto me.
So he doesn't, you're not squishing his head there?
No. So we just give his venom glands a gentle massage. Now, not enough pressure to hurt him, but just enough to stimulate the venom glands to give that little bit more venom. As you can see, he's given an absolute ton. He's pretty keen on the chewing, because he still reckons he's bitten me.
And that's going to go towards saving people's lives.
So this will be turned into anti-venom, and this will save lives. But anyway, got to get going. Catch you later, guys, and see you next time.
Thank you. Look, this is a lace monitor. Look at the ladies feeding them.
Is that it?